Hey everybody, it's your boy Dino Dean.
And the First Lady of Food, Miss Coretta.
And we're the Black Foodies.
Today we are on the south side of Chicago in the Kenwood community, and the place is called Some Like It Black Bar and Cafe. Guys, they have live entertainment, great music, and also, you know what we came for? Outstanding food. You ready, Miss Coretta?
I'm ready.
Let's let them see what it's all about. Guys, I am here with owner of Some Like It Black, one of the co-owners, Micah Crawford. What's going on, sis?
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing phenomenal. Tell us about the concept of the place.
So Like It Black is a business that was started approximately 15, 20 years ago down in South Loop. And it showcased lots of local artists in the community and was just a place for people to come and express themselves through their artistry. So when we reopened in 2016, we added food to our establishment. So here we are.
What made you choose the Kenwood community?
You know, we have a long history in this community. We used to live over here. I went to high school, at King. So, it's a long history with Bronzeville.
And tell us why the people come in for the food. We are the Black Foodies.
Yeah, when people come in, I really didn't know that the tacos were gonna be, as popular as they are, but I'm glad they are, So everyone loves everything when they come here. It's just good cooking, We make it personable, we welcome. I put my love into everything that I make, so I think that really shows. We have quite a few different things that we have here at Some Like It Black. We do live poetry once a month. We have live music twice a month.
Okay.
We do like a 90s R&B night every Thursday. So we're trying to amp up things and bring more events as we go along. So you can check out our website for all those things. SomeLikeItBlack.com.
SomeLikeItBlack.com.
Mm-hmm. So we have a re-grand opening coming up March 30th. Some Like It Black has evolved. Now we have a full service bar in our establishment that we're really excited about, to bring another aspect of fun, to the Bronzeville community. So we're encouraging people to come out in their 1960s attire. We're gonna have fun, come dressed up. If not, if you don't want to, it's cool too.
Okay.
But we plan on having a lot of fun.
Well, Micah, thank you so much for having us in your establishment. And we're about to get down with the get down and try some of these tacos.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
All right, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Guys, I absolutely adore tacos. It's one of the best things that have come from south of the border. And I'm going to start off right now with two of their signature tacos, the veggie taco, and it has yellow squash, zucchini, red onion, cilantro, and I poured a little bit of that verde sauce on top as well. Let's give it a go. For you veggie lovers, for you vegetarians, for you vegans, this is the taco for you. The veggies are absolutely vibrant and fresh, farm fresh as a matter of fact. The verde sauce has a nice, slow, mild kick to it. Man, very quality taco. And I love the tortilla, black corn. Man, I'm smacking. You got it going on. And now on to the jerk chicken taco. God, this jerk chicken taco is absolutely spectacular. And what really stands out, I can taste the warm spices of the allspice on the chicken. The chicken is tender, very quality jerking that was done with this piece. And some of the heat is starting to come through with the habanero in this jerk chicken taco, guys. And it's a slow heat and it's just starting to just roll to the back of the tongue. Man, you gotta love it. And once again, the black corn tortillas and farm fresh veggies, guys. Very quality taco. and I'm going to wash these tacos down with one of their phenomenal cocktails, and it's called the Mississippi Goddamn. And it's actually an old song from Nina Simone. That's where they got the name from. And it's similar to a tequila sunrise. It has tequila blanco, some agave, and some other good stuff in it, guys. I'm about to check it out right now. What I do taste is the lime. The lime is very prominent in it, and I'm a lime head anyway. This is absolutely spectacular. Not too strong, perfect amount of alcohol. Guys, some like it black. Come on down, check them out. It's all good. And get one of these phenomenal cocktails. The Mississippi, shut your mouth. It's panini time, guys, and I'm going to try this grilled vegetable panini. Same veggies that came on the taco, but it's all held together with pepper jack cheese. Take a look at it. This is very good. It's hot. Fresh out the panini. The bread is grilled to perfection. Once again, the veggies are firm fresh. And this pepper jack cheese, oh man, I love pepper jack cheese. Now I'm gonna let Miss Coretta tell you about their signature panini.
All right guys, I am getting ready to try their most popular panini, the soul panini. And it has collard greens, turkey breast, roasted red peppers, and pepper jack cheese. That burst of flavor from the collard greens just hit me right away. The turkey breast is perfect. The roasted red peppers and the pepper cheese is just blending so well together. It's like Thanksgiving on a panini, but it's so nice and fresh. And everything is nestled inside of an organic wheat bread, grilled to perfection, just tasting so yummy. I'm getting ready to wash this panini down with their house-made lemonade called Black Girl Magic. It's lemonade with activated charcoal. It's so lemony. It's not too sweet, just the way I like it. And the activated charcoal, it's a detox, so it's healthy too. So come get you some of this Black Girl Magic. Got it going on.
Guys, right now we're going to give you our recap on Some Like It Black Bar and Cafe. And as you guys know, our ranking system goes off of kisses. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 being the best. Ready, Miss Coretta?
I'm ready.
One kiss. Two kisses. Three kisses. Four kisses, guys. Some Like It Black has the bomb tacos, the bomb paninis, and also the bomb cocktails. And make sure you come out March 30th for their grand reopening. It's going to be on and cracking.
And if you have a restaurant you would like for us to review, email us at theblackfoodies@gmail.com.
Theblackfoodies@gmail.com. We're out of here, guys. One love.
Bye.